When I look at Stockholm plus 50, one, it is the time to reflect back 50 years to date. What have we achieved in the field of environment?
In 1972, we began creating environmental policies, environmental agencies. And now, as we look into the future, we need to realize that we need more policy coherence, more political consistency, and that can be done under this wonderful framework that Stockholm gave us 50 years ago.
CITES, 1973, CMS, 79, CBD climate change desertification, 1992, Basel Convention, Rotterdam Convention, persistent organic pollutants, prior informed consent. All these are the developments in the last 50 years. Virtually today, globally, every country has a ministry or department on issues related to environmental management, which was not the case in 1972. But for all this, again, we come back. Implementation and enforcement still a matter to deal with. And this is where we should learn lessons and take us to the next 50 years.
You know, the big question for me always, and you know, people often lose sight of it because of all the close work that we're doing, is, you know, why are we doing this? This is about intergenerational justice. This is about not condemning our children and grandchildren to a world of famine and fire and flood.
Probably the biggest lesson into the future is how we integrate all the conventions, all global actions in ways that can help minimize the impact of climate change and pollution, and most importantly, in the tasks and challenges associated to implement the Sustainable Development Goals.